Good morning, Centerville. Welcome to another Friday Focus. Come join us while we play soccer, bring you a Spirit Chain recap, highlight the back of Central Cafe, and talk to some teachers about their fears. October 22nd, and I'm Jaden Walsworth. This week, Mascom took on the boys' soccer team in an intense 3v3.
How's it going, Centerville? We're back with Mascom Tries. Today we're playing Centerville Boys Soccer. I'm Jeff.
I'm Kendall.
This is Drew.
Caleb.
Nate.
Luke.
Max.
All right, let's see who will win.
Are we going to actually?
Yeah. All right. He asked us to.
All right.
Are we starting?
Yeah. We're starting. Wait, Luke.
Yeah. Score.
I don't want to hit Jeff, dude.
There we go.
Dude, my thing keeps falling off. I just hold it. Finish it. Just finish it. Yeah. You want to, like, spice it up, do something? What do you want to do? We could go. One of you with Drew, one of you with me.
Yeah. All right. Switching up teams. Yeah, we could. Oh, good ball.
Kendall.
Come on, Jeff.
Fitness, baby. Yeah, Kendall, finish.
Oh! Back to
Oh.
My
life is all I have. Oh, you good?
Hey! Let's go! Hey!
You got turf burn now?
Yep.
Yeah. Just give him. Yeah, shoot it. Oh my God. Nate, get it back.
Let's go.
Are you? Kendall, step in. Oh. You're in.
Alright.
Oh my God. Yeah.
Do a game winning moves. Kendall and I brush you into the shape kind of
color. Alright, facts.
That's facts. Oh!
Okay, I'm gonna do crossbar into the other side of the goal.
Go, try to go bottom left. Hey!
And that's why Jeffrey sticks to editing. Better luck next time, Mascom. Now let's dope back to last week and see all the fun that was had on Spirit Week.
I got a bad idea.
Take a little bit of time to play. I got a plan. I got a soccer.
Wow, way to show up, Centerville. Tired when you go to school? Check out the back of Central Cafe for your morning boost. I know I'll be there tomorrow morning. This week, we learned about some crazy fears our teachers had. Let's hear what they have to say.
Testing. What is your biggest fear? Probably cotton balls.
Jello. Anything with the consistency of Jello.
Where did this fear root from?
I don't know, but I just don't like touching them. They're kind of just dry feeling and ugh.
I have no idea. When I was little, I was in like kindergarten, and someone brought one of those little like blocks of Jello, and it started moving, and I just threw up all over. So then I was like that kid that had on every, you know, like no peanuts, no this, no Jello squares. I ruined every birthday.
What is your response to it seeing
here? It's like nails on the chalkboard, just kind of like. Bleh.
I just gag. Yeah, I see it move if I don't even go down that aisle in the grocery store. My kids have never had Jell-O, ever.
Will they ever have Jell-O?
No, not in my presence.
Do you think this fear is common or normal, or do you agree it is kind of crazy?
I think it's definitely not normal.
It's ridiculous. But I mean, and people, like my students think it's funny, they'll bring in Jell-O, like the ha-ha. No, it's like people that are afraid of like things in costumes and, you know, it's not fair.
My dad decided to tell me after I was an adult that he had the same thing, and I was like, that's awesome.
So is it genetic?
I think it's genetic, yeah.
What do you have to say to anyone that will now like try to joke with you?
I will be really sad if someone brings Jell-O in. Really sad. My feelings will be hurt.
I don't like you.
How does Spalding clean his ears? I guess we'll never know. We leave you with the choir program's rehearsal for their fall concert. If you missed last night, you have another opportunity to come tonight. Have a good week, Centerville.
My God, this reminds me.